Hello guys, how are you?
Very good, thank you. How are you?
So, yeah, great, thank you. So tell me how you got involved in this project.
So I had recently graduated from drama school and Alid, the director, came into the cafe that I was working in and he was with another colleague of mine from drama school, Erwan, who's also in Scopophobia. And he had, I think, pretty much had cast all of the other main characters in the film, all of the other girls. So you were cast, so this was all happening, but he hadn't cast Rhiannon yet. So he came into the cafe, we met, and suddenly he turned to Erwan and said, Catherine, she went to drama school with you. How is that? How is she? And then we had a Zoom call when I was in Swansea and Alid was in America. And then we read a bit of the script together and one thing led to another and I was cast as Rhiannon. And I'm so grateful that this happened.
As Catherine said, my story is a little bit different. Aled, the director, and I were very good friends in school. We also did a lot of Amdram together, so basically he'd seen me work in a weird way. And he said, I've got this script, Beth, and this character was written with you in mind from when I knew you in school. So I took that on board, read the script. He nailed it, very much me in school. I'm very much a different person now, but so that's what excited me most about it. Yeah.
So did you guys have any challenging moments? And also a little add on to that question, what was your highlights of the filming the film as well? I'll start with you.
The challenging moments were the fact that I've never actually done screen acting before. This is my first screen acting gig. I'm a stage person. So the real sort of challenge for me was getting over that initial fear of the camera being very, very close to your face. And then just working through the little nuances that you need to do, the little changes you need to make to the way you perform. And my highlight from it, I think the stunt work is fun. Isn't it fun?
Yeah. It's thrilling, yeah.
Yeah, so yeah, I enjoyed doing all the kind of getting bloodied up and all this kind of stuff. Lots of fun. Yeah.
I think for me, the biggest challenge was the fact that we were working with such a small budget, and having now seen it, I'm so proud of what we achieved with a small budget, because maybe you can't even tell, but knowing the filming and how it worked, we had to do a lot of scenes in a very short amount of time. I think if we had the luxury of time and the luxury of money, then maybe things that weren't quite right, we wouldn't have been rushing scenes. There was, what I can remember from filming was it would be 5 a.m. and we'd been filming since 8 p.m. So, and it was deep into the night. Everybody was exhausted, but we just had to do like one more take because what needed to be filmed in that block had to be filmed. There was no time for error. So maybe sometimes as an actor, you feel like one more take would have been perfect, but you didn't have that luxury. So you had to just, from the moment that action was called, you had to be in it. And there was no real room for, oh, my line, what was that? Or, oh, I wasn't so happy with that. Or I didn't really feel it in this take. It was just, let's go, let's get it done. So many scenes filmed in such a short amount of time. But I think it added to the love for it and it added to the passion. And then my highlight is how close we all became as a cast and as a crew. I love these people so much. And today has been a bit of a reunion, I think, for a lot of us, because we finished filming a year and a half ago. And here we are today. And it feels like no time has passed at all. And especially the four girls, the other three girls that, you know, we play the four together. I mean, you guys are some of my best friends now. And we didn't even know each other before.
I know, that's so true. That's so true.
It's just beautiful. It's just a real lifelong friendship that's been
it's just
curated from a film. And we were forced into this, not forced, we all chose to be here. But we were put into this group together. And how amazingly it worked. I'm so happy for us. And I'm so glad that we met.
I've got to hurry up a little bit, but I've got two. Well, first thing, I think it's remarkable that you said it was a low budget film. Remarkable that you're in the most famous cinema in the world and it's been shown in there. How does that feel?
I mean, pull the other one. It's incredible. I keep having to pinch myself.
Yeah.
Incredibly nervous getting here.
Yeah.
But I mean, thank you, Fright Fest, for giving us this platform, for one thing. And it's just so cool to see our little film up there on the big screen in some real comfortable seats.
Oh, those seats were fantastic. Really fantastic seats. I think from the very day one, I never could have seen something like this in Scopophobia's future in Leicester Square. And to play to a pretty much full audience as well.
Very exciting.
It was an absolute honor. The whole day has felt like an honor, and the whole day has felt like something I can't believe is happening. I can't believe that we're here in a media wall talking about the film, the little small budget film that we made in Wales. It's completely...
Two little Welsh girls.
Two Welsh girls. Just here. I never saw this happening for us, but I'm also not surprised because of the amount of passion, work and energy that was put in from all angles.
And then lastly, what can we expect from you guys in the future? And if you can quickly add on to that, if you can sum up this film in three words, what words would you sum them up in?
Future.
In terms of the future for me, the world is my oyster. I've just got back from travelling around New Zealand for 7 months, so this is the most exciting thing that's happened since then, so hopefully more exciting things happen after then. Three words to sum up Scopophobia:
Welsh.
Gritty. Go on, number three for you.
Passion, right?
Yeah.
Passion. And then in the future for me, so I'm actually currently living in Berlin, or I was living in Berlin, and I just hope to keep acting, and I really hope to see where Scopophobia can go. We have our next screening in Wales, in Carmarthen, in 2 weeks' time, so can't wait for that. I can't wait for my family to see it as well. Three words to sum it up: Welsh, twisty. Is twisty a word?
Twisty.
And I know you can do the third word, because...
And... Frightening.
Guys, thank you so much. I really appreciate that. And enjoy the rest of today.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.